Okay, we're going to solve this equation. 2x plus 4.5 is equal to 10.7. Here we go. First, you see that we have this number right here. We are going to get rid of that. And to do so, we can just minus 4.5. And of course, you do the same thing on the other side as well, right? Minus the same number on both sides. And then on the left-hand side, we just have 2x left. And we'll bring down the equal sign and work this out. 10.7 minus 4.5, we will end up with 6.2, like this. And lastly, this is 2 times x, so to get rid of the 2, we will just divide both sides by 2, like this. Cancel, cancel. And finally, we can see that x is equal to 6.2 divided by 2, and that's just going to be 3.1. And that is it. And usually, when the question starts with decimal, you can just end up with decimal. You don't have to change to fraction. So that's it. All right, we're going to solve the equation. 2 over 3x is equal to 10 over 27. Here we go. Notice that we have 2 over 3 times x. So to get rid of the 2 over 3, we'll divide it by 2 over 3. But dividing a fraction, it's the same as multiply by its reciprocal. So in fact, for this one, let me just multiply by its reciprocal, namely 2 over 3 right here. And again, we do the same thing on the other side. So we multiply this by 2 over 3, like this. And the beauty of doing this so is that when we multiply fractions, we can actually cross-cancel. And you see, 3 and 3 cancel, 2 and 2 cancel. So this right here is just going to give us 1x. So the x is by itself now, which is very nice. So we have x is equal to, and then for the second part right here, we have 3 over 2 times 10 over 27. Well, you can multiply the top and top and then divide it by multiply the bottom and bottom, but you can cross-reduce. So you see that 3 and 27, 3 goes into 3 one time, and 3 goes into 27 9 times. So cross-reduce. And likewise, 2 goes into 2 one time, and 2 goes into 10 5 times. It's much easier if you do it this way, right? Have a look. Finally, we will just see 1 times 5, which is 5 on the top, and then 1 times 9, which is just 9 on the bottom. So finally, the answer is 5 over 9 for the x. Okay, we're going to solve the equation. 5x plus 1 over 3 is equal to 1 over 2. So here we go. Well, as usual, we'll try to get rid of this first. We are adding 1 over 3, therefore we have to subtract 1 over 3 on both sides of the equation. So this and that will be canceled out. And then we see that we will just have 5x, and that's equal to 1/2 minus 1/3. And yes, I will show you guys the work on the side. Have a look. 1 over 2 minus 1 over 3. To subtract fractions, we need to have the common denominator. And when we have 2 and 3, the common denominator is going to be 6. Right? And to get to 6, you just ask yourself, 2 times 4 gives you 6. And the answer to that is 3. So you multiply this by 3, and you also multiply the top by 3. When we see 1 times 3, that's just going to give us 3. And then for the second part, you ask yourself, 3 times 4 will give you 6. And the answer to that will be 2. And you also do the same thing on the top. 1 times 2 is 2, just like this. And then when they have the same denominator, you can subtract them, just do the top. 3 minus 2, we get 1. And divided by the denominator stays the same. So we have 1 over 6. Then we'll come back. 1 over 2 minus 1 over 3 is just nicely equal to 1 over 6, like this. Now, we have 5 times x is equal to 1 over 6. To get rid of the 5, usually we divide it by 5. But on the right-hand side, we have a fraction already. So remember, divided by 5, it's the same as multiplied by its reciprocal. So, in this situation, let me multiply by 1 over 5 on both sides. And the reason is because, you see, the right-hand side is a fraction already. That's writing in the fraction form. It's easier to work it out this way, right? 1 over 5 times 5, let me tell you, this right here still cancels to be 1. So, if you put down divided by 5, divided by 5, that doesn't look nice. This right here is slightly easier for us. And we see x is equal to... And this right here, we can just multiply the top and top together, which is 1 over 5 times 6, which is 30. So finally, we see that x is equal to 1 over 30. Okay, we'll solve this equation. And you see that we have a parenthesis. So go ahead and work that out first. So here we go. Right here, I will just take the positive 2 and distribute. And we see here we have the 4, just write it down, and then work this out. 2 times m is just 2m, and that's positive, so we have plus 2m right here. And then positive 2 times negative 3, we get minus 6, like this. And then the right-hand side, since we didn't do anything with it, we'll just write it down. All right, now on the left-hand side, ask yourself, can you compile anything? Yes, this and that, right? This and that. 4 minus 6, we can totally just combine them. So actually, let me put down the 2m first. And then 4 minus 6, that will give us negative 2, right? And the right-hand side again, I'll just leave it as how it is. We have negative 3m plus 8. Finally, we are going to move the part with the variables to the other side and then the number to the other side. So for the minus 3m, let's go ahead and add 3m to it so that this and that will be canceled it. But we have to do the same thing on the other side, like this. In the meantime, we have the minus 2. So let's go ahead and add 2 here and add 2 here so that minus 2 and plus 2 will be canceled it. And you see that the left-hand side, this and that, is just 5m. And that's equal to 8 plus 2, which of course is 10. Lastly, this is 5 times m. So we'll just divide both sides by 5, like this. So just put it as over 5. And 10 over 5 is going to be 2. So final answer, m is equal to 2, just like this. OK, we are going to solve this equation. So here we go. As we can see, we have parentheses. So of course, go ahead and work that out first, right? Namely, we have to take the number in front and distribute. So focus on this first. 2 times 5x, that will give us 10x. And then 2 times positive 3, that will give us plus 6. And then we continue for the second part right here. Minus 3, right, but with a parenthesis. So we'll take this and multiply. Have a look. We have negative 3 times 2x, that will give us negative 6x. And then negative 3 times positive 1, that will give us negative 3, like this. And then on the right-hand side, we still have 53, like that. All right, on the left-hand side, though, we see that we have the 10x minus 6x. So combine them, we get 4x. And the plus 6 minus 3, that will give us plus 3, right? 6 minus 3, we get positive 3. And the right-hand side is still equal to 53, like this. Okay. To finish this, now we can just minus 3 on both sides so that we get 4x, and that's equal to, work that out, we get 50. And lastly, we can just divide the 4 on both sides because this is 4 times x. So divide the 4 on both sides, this and that will be canceled it. And don't forget to do the same thing on the other side. So finally, we get x by itself, and that's equal to, well, we have 50 divided by 4. Can we reduce that? Yes. We can reduce this by 2. So divided by 2, divided by 2. Finally, we can say the answer is 25 on the top over 2 on the bottom. And if you would like, for this part, you can also use decimal, which will be 12.5. And notice that you can use decimal if the decimal ends, right? 12.5 ends. If the decimal does not end, we will just write the answer in terms of fractions, right? So you can do it like this, or you can also say x is equal to 12.5. But this is better. All right, we're going to solve this equation. Here we go. First, we see that we have this number in front of the parentheses. Of course, go ahead and take negative 3. Distribute. So negative 3 times 2x, we will get negative 6x. And then negative 3 times positive 1, that will give us negative 3. And bring down the equal sign, and we'll do the same thing. Take the 5, distribute, so we get 5x, and 5 times 3 is plus 15, like this. And then for the last one right here, we will take the negative 2, right? Be careful, this is a negative 2. Take this and distribute. First, negative 2 times positive 4x, that will give us negative 8x. And then when we do negative 2 times the 7 here, that will give us negative 14. So be really careful with the sign changes right here. All right, now on the left-hand side, there's nothing we can do. But on the right-hand side, we can combine like terms. We see that the 5x and the minus 8x, we can combine them, right? So let's go ahead and first let me just write this down again. 5x minus 8x, that will give us negative 3x. And then continue. We see that 15 minus 14. That's going to be positive 1. So that's what we have. All right, to finish this up, all we have to do is move the x to the other side and move this number to the other side and then clean up the coefficients later on. So for this, let's go ahead, add the 3x on both sides so that this and that will be cancelled, and we do the same thing here. And this is minus 3, so we add 3 here, so that this and that will be cancelled. All right, we have this plus that. That will give us negative 3x. Right, negative 6 plus 3, that's negative 3. And then you keep the x term. And that's equal to 1 plus 3, that's 4, just like that. And finally, be really careful with this one. This means negative 3 times x. So we will have to divide both sides by negative 3. We have to divide both sides by negative 3 because this is a multiplication. All right, cancel this out. Finally, we get x equals 4 over negative 3. You can put the negative on the bottom, in the front, or on the top. Up to you, whenever we have a negative fraction. Usually, I like to put it like in the front or maybe on the top. So I'll write it as negative 4 over 3, like this. Right? And again, you could have leave it as negative 4 on the top over 3, or 4 over negative 3, like that. And yeah, doesn't really matter. And I meant to put it in the front like this. Right? It's either this one or that one. That's usually preferred. And that's it.